In RuneScape's first stage, an experiment was conducted by one of the dragonkin, trying to replicate the Queen Black Dragon's power. But it failed, and so the creature was cast into the wilderness to be forgotten. And for more over a decade, no one knew it was even there. But then, whispers started to spread, talking about an unknown danger living deep in the wilderness, a creature that would soon be known as the King Black Dragon. The King Black Dragon's lair is located below the lava maze, deep in the northwestern part of the wilderness. But don't be afraid, the Dragon's lair is not considered a PvP zone. When it comes to getting there, you have two different options. The easy and safe one, or the harder and way more dangerous one. In both cases, you have to interact with an artifact that has the ability to teleport you into the boss room. The first artifact can be found at the border between Edgeville and the wilderness. Simply use the lodestone to Edgeville and run a couple of steps to the northwest. Guarded by a flock of sheep, you will find the first artifact. For the second one, you need to traverse the fine line between life and death that is called the wilderness. You can either do that by walking all the way up there, or by first using the wilderness lodestone and then teleporting around with the obelisks, which, after interacting with one, will randomly teleport you to one of the others that are scattered all throughout the wilderness. Simply teleport around until you see some snow on your minimap, which indicates you arrived at the northwestern one. But why would you choose the dangerous one over the safe and easy way anyways? Well, if you enter the fight with the wilderness artifact, you will gain a 10% damage boost. So if you plan on staying here for a longer period of time, this might be worth it. But that's up to you to decide. Just a word of advice, if you want to use the dangerous way, switch to a low populated RuneScape world, because it really helps with avoiding those PKers. Whichever way you choose, once you click on an artifact, the boss encounter screen will pop up. Here you have the choice of joining the public boss instance or to create your own one. Also note, if you pay for your private instance, it will stay open for 1 hour, no matter what. So in case you need to bank or restock on supplies, you can simply use the rejoin button to re-enter your own instance without having to pay another fee. Before we even start speaking about what gear to bring, there is one thing that you absolutely need. Dragonfire protection. There are three main ways of protecting yourself. The classic anti-dragon shield or its bigger brother, the dragonfire shield. Secondly, the anti-fire potion, and lastly, the super anti-fire potion. Out of them all, the anti-dragon shield is the easiest one to obtain, as it will be given to you during the quest Dragonslayer. Using a draconic visage on it while having at least 90 smithing will net you the dragonfire shield. Although having better stats overall, both shields provide the same protection against the standard dragonfire attack. You could also attach a clingy mole to the anti-dragon shield, requiring 45 crafting. The clingy mole is a rare drop from the giant mole boss and can also be bought from other players. The resulting shield will further increase your dragonfire protection, making it so that you can take more than 100 damage from dragon breath attacks. The anti-fire potion can be made as soon as level 69 herb lore, and in combination with an anti-dragon shield will provide full dragonfire protection. This will, however, not protect you against the King Black Dragon's special attacks, which we'll talk about later. Also note that, although it's quite hard to find confirmed information about it, the anti-fire potion doesn't seem to provide the same protection as an anti-dragon shield does. Although both add up to 100% dragonfire resistance, the anti-dragon shield roughly provides 75% of it and the potion only gives you the remaining 25%, so don't worry if you can't access it yet. The super anti-fire potion is pretty much the gold standard when it comes to dragonfire protection, giving you 100% immunity. This enables you to use two-handed or dual-wielded weapons and therefore impacting your DPS in a significant way, as you don't need to bring that old dusty shield. In addition, it also provides some protection against the KBD's special attacks. Sadly, this potion cannot be bought from other players and requires you to have at least 85 herb lore in order to make it, so this is more of an endgame option. You will find a wiki link to all the items I just mentioned in the description down below. The gear you should use highly depends on the one-handed weapons that are available to you. For example, even though I have level 78 in magic, I only have a T50 wand, and although my melee combat stats are way lower, the simple fact that I can use a T60 melee weapon results in both styles having about the same kill time, taking about 3 to 3.5 minutes. Generally speaking, if you have a T60 weapon along with 60 plus combat stats, you should be good to go. But keep in mind that you will most likely need to restock on food after 1 or 2 kills. For the endgame players out there, if you are using things like soul split, overloads, power armor and so on, you won't even have to bring any food at all, and you will get your kills done in about 20 to 30 seconds. The fight itself is pretty straightforward. Use your potions if you brought any and start spamming your skills. If you've chosen ranged or magic as your combat style, the King Black Dragon will also attack from a distance, mostly using his Dragon Breath attack. If you engage him with melee, he can also use melee attacks, but most of the time will still rely on his Dragon Breath. Along with these standard attacks, he also has three special abilities. The first one being a poisonous dragonfire. When hit by this attack, a weak poison will be applied to you. You can bring along an anti-poison, but it's not a must-have and the damage taken is mostly negligible. Also note that if you are a free-to-play player, this attack will not inflict poison on you. His second ability is a freezing dragonfire that will bind you in place, but you can still attack him, so you can pretty much ignore this attack. And last but not least, he can use a shocking dragonfire. If you get hit by it, it can lower all your stats by 2 and drain a couple of your summoning points. Even if you are fully protected against this standard dragonfire attack, the special abilities I just mentioned will still deal some damage to you, even though it's just a fraction of the damage you would take without anti-fire protection. The King Black Dragon's most expensive drops are the Dragon Rider boots and gloves and of course the Draconic Visage. Because the mentioned drops are very rare, you are most likely to get some of the more ordinary loot like locks, runes or salvage. Therefore, I would not recommend you to kill this boss if all you want is profit, because there are far better alternatives out there when it comes to generating currency. The King Black Dragon also has access to the rare drop table, but according to the Runescape wiki, you always have a chance to roll on it, so you don't need to bring a luck enhancing item like the Ring of Valve for example. Thank you so much for watching, I hope you enjoyed the video and if you learned anything new, please consider leaving a like, I would really appreciate it. Just like every time, you will find all the useful links down in the description below, as well as the links to the music I used in this video. Until next time, I wish you the best of luck and farewell, Dragonslayer.